Hello and welcome to EQ International Magazine, India's oldest and leading social media. And today we have Mr. AK Jain with us from Insulation Energy. Hello sir, welcome to EQ.
Hi.
Sir, can you just let us know about Insulation Energy and what are your plans, upcoming plans for 2021 and as well as target for 2022 and the anything new technology we have come up with in modules?
See, in India, the National Solar Mission, when it was announced, we had a target of 20 gigawatt. But that 20 gigawatt was done without any manufacturing. The biggest challenge which we see in the country is when this target was revised to 100 gigawatt of solar and 175 gigawatt of the renewable. And an entire capacity building, again the manufacturing was a big challenge. So what our Honorable Prime Minister said, that let us do everything with Atmanirbhar and Make in India. So this is where the installation has come on its own way, starting from 70 megawatt to 120 megawatt and now to 700 megawatt. So recently they have just laid the foundation stone for another 500 megawatt manufacturing facility. Now this is that installation. But if we look at country, we probably need the 35 gigawatt of manufacturing across the country. And why this capacity is needed? Because we need to serve our country to realize the vision of one sun, one world, and one grid. So not only to India, rather we have to serve many more countries. More important, we are going to be 5 trillion economy and then the 10 trillion economy. So we will become only a 10 trillion economy until unless we develop those capacities, particularly the manufacturing and the energy capability through Make in India and through Atmanirbhar. So 35 gigawatt of manufacturing, a huge technology base is to be created for storage also, because somewhere we all are seeing that electric mobility is going to happen. So by 2030, our target of renewable energy is 450 gigawatt. And if we couple the electric mobility, probably this target needs to be revised, maybe after 3 years or 4 years, because electric mobility would need extra power. So, and coupled with the storage also, we would need that kind of power.
Sir, as you know, there are many international brands who are coming up in India and they are tying up with the Indian manufacturers in the solar industry. So what's your view on that? Like, will it be challenging for the Indian manufacturers or is it an opportunity? We see it as an opportunity what's your view on the same?
See, I believe when the cake is big, there's opportunity for everybody. And so as is India. India is the fastest growing economy, particularly to handle with the renewable energy initiatives. So I do not think there will be any challenge for any global player to cooperate and collaborate with Indian companies, or even Indian company to collaborate and cooperate with any of the global players. So it's going to be a global lens for manufacturing, for in terms of taking projects, in terms of taking renewable energy ahead, in terms of creating a climate environment, and even meeting the targets of carbon neutral.
Like how many modules we have till now, like manufactured in India? In India, how much we have supplied?
Insulation has so far deployed around 250 megawatt in last few years, but it has a target set to touch something around 1,000 megawatt in another 3 years from now. And if we talk about the country, then in India also, the Indian manufacturers would have contributed around 15 to 20% of the modules which are already installed by the Indian manufacturers. But in time to come, yes, India look forward for 30 to 35 gigawatt to be manufactured and to be commissioned in India and across the globe.
And what are the export plans for insulation energy? Like, are we planning to export internationally? We are taking to international market as well.
Yes, my previous company where I have worked for 38 years, so I always learned one thing, that why not to work across the borders. So the same mentorship I'm doing at Insulation. So they definitely do have plans to undertake export projects through International Solar Alliance and many more opportunities which are available in the nearby countries.
As there are set targets that are being set by the government, so do you think, like, would it be achievable or it would be challenging, like how it would be?
Oh, I have no doubt. Two reasons. One, I have worked in PSU. The second reason, I am now connected to the private industry. And I know the way private industries are marching ahead, the way challenges are being sorted out between the government and private industry. I'm confident that this target will also be achieved, as all the targets have been achieved so far by the present government.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot for being with us.
Right. Thank you.